Next this lunchtime, it's 20 years since the outbreak of the foot and mouth crisis, which led to millions of farm animals being slaughtered. And on the anniversary, farmers are saying people need to learn lessons from that crisis to stop the spread of COVID-19. Dennis Archer from South Derbyshire lost all his pedigree cattle to the disease. He says people should stick to restrictions like farmers did in 2001. Emma Snow has this report.
In 2001, smoke bellowed above many farms in the UK. It was a scene that farmers still find hard to talk about, like Dennis Archer, a farmer in Marston-on-Dove in South Derbyshire.
Well, it's always a big worry when foot and mouth are announced in the country, because you wonder how far it's going to spread. And then when our neighbour phoned up, I think in the middle of March, to say he got foot and mouth, it was with disbelief, really, to start off with.
Despite locking down the farm, Dennis's cattle still became infected and he lost all his pedigree cattle, which went back many generations.
What was very upsetting for me was I had to milk those cows that night and the following morning, because if they're giving sort of 7 or 8 gallons of milk a day, you can't just leave them. It's cruel because they get so much pressure on their udders. So I had to milk them knowing that next day they were going to be slaughtered. There was 40, 50, 60, 70, 80 with it. And you just wanted to see them slaughtered, really, to put them out of the misery.
20 years ago, this field would have looked very different. Because of foot and mouth disease, Dennis went from dairy farming into arable farming.
It was very, traumatic, and the thought of having to go through all that again, which I know it was fairly unlikely, but it goes through your mind. It's quite pertinent, really, that we're talking about this 20 years after, when we've got this coronavirus thing going on, and we realise probably more than most people how quickly a virus can spread, when we've actually seen it firsthand.
Emma Snow, BBC East Midlands Today in South Derbyshire.